Are you interested in becoming an airline pilot? And are you wondering, what should I expect during flight school? Or when are they gonna start letting me fly the big jets? You're in the right place. Stay tuned.
963 heavy, flighting 190, maintain 10,000, runway 18 left, clear for takeoff.
Hey guys, I'm Kelsey, I'm a 747 pilot. I currently am flying international long haul. Prior to that, I did regional flying on a CRJ 900. And before that, I was flying for a corporate charter company. So that's my background. I'm gonna be going over what to expect during flight school, some things you can expect after flight school, when you'll be able to qualify to start flying jets, and when you'll start being able to get large jets. I'm gonna be covering mostly stuff in the US, but as well as some international stuff for any of you people that are planning on going back overseas or outside the US. So the three things you're gonna wanna complete in flight school are gonna be your private pilot license, your instrument rating, and your commercial rating. There'll be a few variables in there, like do you have a commercial multi-engine or a commercial single engine? And in some later videos, we'll kind of get into more discussions of that, but those are the three main tasks you need to focus on. What I always recommend and what I tell my friends is just break it up into three separate groups mentally. Focus on completing one task at a time. Otherwise, it can start to get a little bit overwhelming. If you go to a flight school and you're gonna go full-time, depending on the flight school you go to, it's gonna take 8 to 18 months, depending on how fast you study, how much you fly, what the availability is on the aircrafts you're gonna fly. A good friend of mine, Chris, who I was at the regionals with, I believe he got through flight school in like 8 months, I think, start to finish. He said it was extremely condensed learning. He did miss some important things that he wished he had been able to pay more attention on, but the whole idea of flight school is to finish flight school so you can get out, start getting hours quickly, start making money.
Show me the money!
That in mind, the idea of completing quickly is not a horrible idea. Most people, what they'll do is pick one location. If they're gonna do it all together, they'll pick one location, they'll go there and they'll do it. If you're doing it part-time, you're gonna break it up probably. And again, my recommendation, if you want to work full-time while getting your pilot license, my advice to you would be save up the money to get each stage done and go in and condensely work on getting that completed. Take 1 or 2 weeks off of work or go part-time and really try to get out there and fly as much as you can until you can complete that. The reason I say that is because I know guys who did it very broken apart, and basically what happens is you're doing 2 lessons in a week or 1 lesson a week on Saturday in the morning for 2 hours. Your brain can only process so much information at one time. So when you get out there and you start flying and you're getting 2 hours a week, you learn some stuff, and then the next week you need to relearn some of that stuff. You're paying for the plane, you're paying for the flight instructor. It's going to take you more time in the long run to complete that. It's still doable. It's just my recommendation would be, if you're serious about doing this, get in and condensely complete each of those licenses and get them done quickly. Your first job is gonna be one of two variables. Once you finish flight school, you're either gonna, depending on the flight school that you go to, you're either going to have 200 or 250 hours of flight time, roughly, maybe a little bit more. Once you finish, you either have the option to A, become a flight instructor, which is what most people do. They go get what's called a CFI, which is a certified flight instructor, and they teach new guys like you, if you're currently in flight school, or guys that are going to go to flight school, they go back and they start teaching them how to fly. It's a good way to gain experience. It's what most guys do, because when you finish flight school with 250 hours, not many people want to hire you. They know you don't have a lot of experience or any experience. 250 hours is not a lot in their mind. That's the primary route that people go to. An alternative to that, if you are able to find it and want to do it this way, is to become a co-pilot generally and start flying on some type of a small cargo operation or small charter operation, and usually a small piston-driven aircraft. There's advantages to both. If you're gonna go become a flight instructor, the advantage is gonna be, generally, you can pick up a lot of flight time very quickly. You do get the experience of teaching other people, which helps you become a better pilot in the sense that things get really clear in your mind. If you're teaching other people how to do things, things get clear in your mind as far as concepts that you learned during flight school become very clear now that you're a flight instructor and having to teach other people that. On the other side of it, if you leave and are able to get a charter job with 300 or so hours, they are few and far between. They are out there though. This is inside the US only that I'm referring to. The benefits of that is you're gonna get a lot more real world experience flying into larger airports. You're gonna be flying in weather that generally your flight students, if you were a flight instructor, would not be flying in. You're gonna be getting actual flight time in clouds and weather and storms and things like that. That type of experience really makes your career easier in the sense of it's not all new to you once you go to the airlines. If you don't have a job lined up and you're planning to go to flight school and then go back and look for a job, my recommendation would to be get time instructing. If that's the only job you can get, start getting flight time built up, because there's a lot of people out there that have their commercial license with 250 hours. Having more than that gives you a lot more options. There's a huge variety of planes that you're gonna be flying in flight school, immediately after flight school, if you get a cargo or that type of job. Once you get to the airlines, again, this is in the US, generally speaking, you're gonna be flying what's called a CRJ or an ERJ. It's a Canadair regional jet. They have 200, 700s, and 900s generally in the US. The 200s are slowly fading away. They're a small 50-seater jet. Then your 700s and 900s, I wanna say that you go up to about 70 seats. And then on the, which is what I flew. I flew the CRJ 700 and 900. Then on the ERJ side, it's an Embraer jet. Sometimes they call it the jungle jet. That's because it's a Brazilian company. So they got the 145s, 170, 175s are generally the aircrafts that the guys are flying at the regionals right now. Those are the types of jets you're gonna be flying once you finish and have those flight hour requirements. Right now in the current market, if you have 1,500 hours or you have 1,000 hours because you went to an accredited school, you can get a job immediately. So there's huge demand right now that's happening at the regional airline level as far as for getting people in the door. There's several factors which caused a drought, if you will, of pilots and people going through flight school. If you're considering going to flight school, you're wondering kind of what are my chances of getting a job? It's about 100%. Assuming you don't have, that you failed every exam and training, or you have a major accident, or a bunch of things on your criminal record, things like that. Obviously, excluding some major obvious factors, if you go through flight school and you come out, you should be able to have a job immediately. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you liked it, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and click the subscribe button over here. There'll be more videos coming out that I'm gonna be addressing a lot of different things that people have been asking me about. I wanna see the comments from you guys as far as for what you guys wanna hear about, what you wanna know, and if it's something that I think would be relevant to most people, I'll go ahead and make a video addressing those things. Look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.